Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about the percent equation. You can solve percent problems using proportion or an equation. In this lesson, we're going to use an equation to solve the three different types of percent problems. The three types are missing the amount, missing the percentage, or missing the base. When it's stated this way, what number is 30% of 85? We are missing the amount. If it's stated as 15 is what percent of 10, obviously we're missing the percentage in that problem. And if it's stated as 75 is 20% of what number, then we're missing the base. So those are the three different types. You're going to make replacements from your original statement into mathematical symbols, and you're going to replace the what or the what percent or what number with a variable. And when I do it, I use the variable that makes sense by what's missing. So if the amount is missing, I use A, the percent I use P, the base I use B, but it doesn't matter what variable you use. You could always use X or N or whatever you prefer. Then you're going to replace the word is with an equal sign. So in each of these statements, you can see there is the word is, that's your equal sign, and replace the word of with a multiplication sign. You can see the word of is also in all three of those statements. If you're putting the percentage into the equation, make sure you change it to its decimal equivalent by dropping that percent symbol and moving the decimal place two places to the left. The first example is what number is 30% of 85? So I'm going to make those four replacements. The what number is going to become the variable, and since we're missing the amount, it's going to be an A, and the is going to become the equal sign. 30% is going to become 0.30, or you could just write 0.3, that would be fine. Of is going to be multiply, and then 85. So I'm going to remove the square that's covering that, and you can see that I have A equals 0.30 times 85. Writing that a little bit more algebraically, I'm going to just write A equals 0.30 in parentheses 85. All you have to do there is multiply those two numbers together to get 25.5, which means 25.5 is 30% of 85. In the second example, we're missing the percent. 15 is what percent of 10? So 15, I'm not going to change. The is going to be the equal sign. What percent? Those two words are my variable, which I'm going to write as P. The of is multiply, and then the 10. What does that look like? It looks like this. 15 equals P times 10. And if you write that algebraically, we could say 15 equals 10P. To solve that, you would divide both sides by 10. The 10s would cancel on the right side, and then you'd have 15 over 10 on the left side. Now, 15 over 10 gives you 1.5, and that's a decimal number. So we want to change it back to a percent by moving the decimal point two places to the right and adding the percent symbol. So 1.5 becomes 150%. And the third type is 75 is 20% of what number? We're missing the base, so what number is going to become B? The is, again, is equal to, the of is multiply, and the 20% I'm going to write as 0.20, or I could just write it as 0.2. Remember that 0 on the end doesn't change the answer, even though if you're working with things where you're talking about significant figures, it might be important. 75 equals 0.20 times B. I'm going to rewrite that as 75 equals 0.2b. And then again, to get rid of the 0.2, I divide both sides by 2 tenths, and the 2 tenths would cancel on the right, giving me just b, and 75 divided by 0.2 is 375. So 75 is 20% of 375. Those are the three different types of percent equations that you might need to use as you solve your problems. Have a fantastic day, and I'll talk to you next time.